I like my money dipped in ketchup. Prepare to make a lot of money. You'll be eating money after you try this method out for making $5,000 per week hosting events. Now, this method works for two big reasons, okay? First off, people prefer learning in person via live events. People don't like colleges because college doesn't teach you how to make money anymore, but people would rather learn to make money in person. Okay, and the second reason why this method works so well is because when you host live events, you can make a lot more money. Here's the amount of money you can make from the internet, maybe $1 sign. Whereas live, when you're hosting a live event and doing something in person, doing a meeting in person, whatever it is in person, you can make a lot more money from a lot fewer people. Now, I'm gonna go over this in detail. I have five steps which I'm gonna show you how you can set up events. Five steps. Number one, setup. I'm gonna show you how to set up your event so everything is automated. Number two, I'm gonna show you how to promote your event. I'm gonna show you four different methods to promoting your event to get the right people coming in. I'll show you the right places to post. Number three, you're gonna need to teach people something at your event. And I'm gonna show you exactly what you can teach people at your event. You don't have to create the content yourself. It's already made for you. And number four is I will show you how to monetize. I'll show you three separate ways that you can monetize, each of them progressively more money. Depends on how aggressive you wanna be. So let's get into this. I'm gonna walk you through how this works step by step so you too can earn up to $5,000 per week hosting your own live events. Let's get it. Woo! I'm pumped about this. So I love this method for very personal reasons. I'll go into this in just a second, but you can earn $5,000 per week hosting events. And as I said, people prefer in-person events and there's a lot more money from events. And I'm gonna be breaking it down for you of how you can make a lot of money with events. But first, you know what? Why is this personal to me? Why is this such a personal method to me? Is because I actually got my start in online marketing by attending events. See, I was lost. In 2008, I had just moved back to LA and I had no idea of how to get started in business, but I knew I wanted to be an entrepreneur. I knew I wanted to start an internet business, just had no idea exactly how to go about it. So what I did was I just looked up local events. I went on meetup.com and Eventbrite and different things around school, boards and stuff. Craigslist I looked at too. And I just tried to find local events going on. People would be talking about how to start a real estate business or how to make money with the internet or all this stuff. And lots of times they were pitching things, right? But I would go to every one of them because I was desperate to learn how to work for myself. I was tired of working a job. I didn't see that in the future for me, just driving to work, being bored as heck and never making any money. It didn't seem like it was a good path for me. So I went to these events every single night. I would go to a different event in Los Angeles. I would drive 3 hours to San Diego to go to an event if there wasn't something happening around LA or Orange County. Why? Why did I put so much time and effort into this? Well, the reason was because I was hungry. I was hungry for success. I wanted success as bad as I wanted air to breathe. I needed it to survive. So I kept going. Because even when they were pitching me, you know, their internet system or their real estate system or their stock trading system, if I could glean a little bit of information from it, just glean something, or maybe from someone in the audience, some piece of intel that would take me further than I already was, I figured the event was worth it. I was slowly but surely clawing my way up the intelligence ladder. And it was life-changing. I attended hundreds of events at this point. So set up events. People love them. People will go to them. People are hungry for them. People are tired of watching YouTube videos. Tell me how many of you in the audience would rather go to a live event than watch me speak. And be truthful. Rather go to a live event. Just type in live event, okay? Or you could type in YouTube. But wouldn't it be better to learn in person? Or even if it was apples to apple, how many of you would rather have a live event from me than go to watch me on YouTube? It's much better. You can learn, you can ask questions, whatever. So the first step to getting this whole thing started is set up an event. And there's two different ways you can set up your event to get a link. One is through meetup.com. Another is through Eventbrite. And the third is through Facebook, okay? So there's three great sites where you can set up events. And you can set up your event on all three of those sites to get the maximum exposure, because what's great is these sites, they have inbuilt audiences, massive inbuilt audiences of people, and they will send out an email, a notification, a text, or whatever to their users in your city about your event if you set it up. So that's really great advantage for you. Set it up on all three platforms. That makes sense. Now, promoting an event is the second thing, and that's the funnest part. For me, I love marketing. I get so excited about marketing. Every single day. I hang out with friends and just discuss marketing stuff, right? I'm launching an infomercial right now. Spent $250,000 invested in setting up an infomercial. That's a lot of money. It's a big gamble. It takes big balls. And I'm excited. It's the biggest gamble I've made in marketing. Most marketing campaigns are free, or they cost $50 to start, right? With ads to see if they work out. This is $250,000. Yeah. I'm excited. And promoting is the best part about doing anything if you love marketing. Now, promotion, you can do it a couple different ways, okay? So check this out. I'm gonna name out some of the best ways to promote your event right here. Now, I advise you take out a notepad and take notes if you're actually gonna put this into effect. Okay, so the best way to do events is gonna be getting people who are already throwing events in your area, who are already getting people to set up, who are already getting people into their events, to have them talk to their people about your events. The reason is because people who like attending events are going to be the best people to attend other events. So what this means is reaching out to hosts of other events and asking them to promote your event is one of the best ways. People who have other events, who have regular groups that meet weekly or monthly, who have groups around even what you're teaching, those are the best match. Say to them, let's say you're hosting an event about teaching people how to start their online business, which is what I encourage you to do, actually. We'll get down to that in number three. But let's say you're teaching people how to start an online business or how to be an entrepreneur. Find other groups that talk about entrepreneurship, real estate, stock trading, online business, networking, whatever it is, and ask them, say, hey, I'm throwing an event. I was wondering if you could send some of your people to my event or tell them about my event. Because hosts, they don't always throw events, but they love it when other people throw events because it gives them a reason to contact and keep that connection strong with their audience. The second method of promotion, which is actually my favorite out of all of this, is flyers, okay? Putting up those tear tab flyers, which are just basically flyers which have tabs, which have the information, and you have a little headline, you have a little text, maybe a little image, and then people can tear information about the event, right? Just kind of like, you know, just like this. You know, it would have, there'd be a piece, you know, it wouldn't be this big, but the point is there'd be information, the person would tear it. So flyers, posting them around on community boards or different places, people might be interested, right? If you go to college, post them around your business school. People are looking to be entrepreneurs, post the flyers around the business school and say, free event, Thursday night in the library, learn how to be an entrepreneur and start creating a little group, right? You could do every Thursday at 6 p.m. Boom, you have a group. And it's good if you have a common event that happens weekly so people know where to go. post at the YMCA, post it at whatever places people gather in your community, and people will start seeing them, right? And you can see if people are interested in them, if they are tearing the tabs, okay? If they're tearing them off, then you get to measure that and you know if your flyer is effective or not. Third way of promoting your event is Facebook groups. Facebook groups are pretty powerful, and you can find local Facebook groups in whatever your area is. Let's say you're in Hamburg, Germany, right? Find local Facebook groups. There might be local events or other stuff. So now you have more ways that you're getting your event out there. You have Meetup, Eventbrite, Facebook itself, you have Facebook groups, you have flyers. So you're starting to get a lot of different ways, and you're gonna pack your event, okay? Again, the goal is to pack your event, and it's fine if too many people show up. Actually, that's the coolest thing that could ever happen, because when there's not enough room for people, let's say you set up the event so 20 people can come, but 50 people come, it makes you look like the coolest dog in town, and it makes your event one of the hottest events to go to. If you turn away 30 people, you can betcha that they're gonna try to come earlier next time, because in everybody's mind, they're thinking something really special is going on here. I have to figure out what information is being shared here, because it makes your event really special. Now, the fourth place to post about your event is, at least in America, this is a popular place, is Nextdoor. It's a local networking app where you can meet neighbors. And this is a great place just to post for local things. So what do you teach? What are you gonna teach these people at this event? Well, you can teach them about anything, frankly. You could teach them about crocheting, you could teach them about woodworking, you could teach them about meditation, you could teach them about getting closer to God, or how many lives you're gonna live, or how many women you're gonna sleep with in heaven. I don't know, whatever you wanna do. But what I encourage you to do, for my own self-serving purposes, because I'm greedy, right? I'm hungry for money, is teach them about entrepreneurship. Teach them about how they could start their own business. Something along those lines. And what's great is, let's say you aren't a successful entrepreneur yet. Okay, it's not bad, it's fine. You can still reteach it. And you have a plethora of content right here. You have hundreds of videos of mine that you can actually just reteach from my channel. This is top quality information, and you can teach it on stage. You're learning these concepts, and one of the best ways to actually really integrate and learn a concept is to be able to teach it, okay? Now, teachers are typically boring. Teachers are typically not animated. Teachers are typically old and stodgy and don't even seem interested by their own content. And what I encourage you to do is be interesting. Don't be like that. Teachers should be exciting and excited, okay? So love what you do. I love what I do. And you can teach people all about affiliate marketing. You could teach them about the different business models, drop shipping. You could teach them about Shopify. You could teach them about the differences between starting a stock trading business versus a real estate versus an online business. You could teach them about the differences between, you know, cash flow positive businesses and cash flow negative businesses, and what are examples of each and why you don't want to start cash flow negative businesses. There's a lot of options available, but the most exciting part is where the money comes in. And let's get into that, because there's three ways you can make money here. And the greatest part is if you're teaching about business, you can make a lot more money than if you're teaching about comedy, right? Or if you're teaching about knitting. You can't sell knitting supplies for a lot of money, but you can sell business supplies for a lot of money. Business supplies meaning, well, let me show you the things you can sell. So the first thing that you could sell, which could make you a little bit of money, is you could recommend people get my training course, in which case we each make $500. My training course is $1,000, and then we split that, and you get my training course through ClickBank, and you can get affiliate link, then you make $500, right? Now, if you wanna make more money, if you wanna start making bigger money here, you can actually set up a live event. You can set up a mastermind group that people pay to be a part of. Kinda interesting. Now, why is that going to be more effective? Well, the reason it's going to be more effective is because people who attend a live event are going to be more interested in learning from another live event, right? Makes sense. So that's just like the best thing to sell digitally is digital products, okay? The best thing to sell live is something else live. It's just similar, so it makes more sense. So you could sell a mastermind. Has anybody gone through Tony Robbins' Knowledge Blueprint course? If you could type in yes in the comments below. Also, if you could type in the comments below if I'm going too fast, too slow, or if the pacing is just right. I want to make sure all of this is kind of making sense and nothing's going over your head, because there's so much depth within each of these that I could go into, but I'm trying to stay a little top down just to keep the video length around 15 minutes, frankly. So mastermind. Now, the third type of way you could make money, which is bigger money, okay? Each of these is successively bigger money, is you could actually sell coaching, or you could sell a seminar, okay? Now, again, if you're doing a seminar, if you're selling coaching where you yourself are presumably the expert, you have to be able to back it up, right? You can't just sell a seminar featuring you yourself if you yourself are not very successful, right, at being an entrepreneur. It's gonna kind of fall apart, or not, who knows. But the point is, you can demand a lot of money for a seminar for personalized coaching, but you also have to be able to deliver. Mastermind is a very good option if you yourself are not an expert in what you teach, but connecting like minds and creating a space for that is worth a lot of money. So if you're looking to connect with peers, you could have 9 people pay you $1,000 each, and you kind of act as the moderator, and you set up the location and facilities each time. Maybe the 9 people pay you $1,000 a year, $1,000 a month, whatever it is, to meet up and be business buddies. Now that's it. It's really not complicated, and it's all very obvious, but it's not talked about in schools, right? This isn't a complicated setup. And you can make a lot of money doing this. You could get 9 people, 10 people paying you $500 a month to be a part of a mastermind group very easily, especially if you use all these marketing methods and your events are oversubscribed every single month, right? Could start it off free and then slowly amp it up, whatever way you want to do it. But the point being is, this is a great way to make money and connect with people in your community. Now, if you're actually going to put this into action and do this, let me know in the chat. Let me just write in the comments, say, I'm gonna try this out. If you don't like this idea, let me know why in the comments about why this is not interesting at all to you. But it is a viable way of making money. And honestly, I implore every one of you to try to find a local event that's happening where you can meet other fellow entrepreneurs who are on the same path. It's really exciting and really motivating, and it really helped me out surrounding myself with all entrepreneurs. It helped me break through the first walls of starting my business. As always, like, subscribe, and comment. I love seeing your guys' faces here. I love seeing my regulars. I hope I'm really helping you all earn money. If I helped you earn money, please send me a video testimonial. Post a video testimonial and tag me in it. I want to see a video, okay? Post it on your YouTube channel and just type my name in it. Type in John Cristani testimonial. I'll find it. Post it on YouTube and then post the link in the comments. You know, I love hearing from all of y'all. I see comments, but what I really want to hear is your story. So talk to you soon. See you in the next video. Hit the notifications if you don't want to miss any more money-making videos. And I forgot one thing. Because this was a money video, we have to throw some money up there. So let's go get it. Put this into action. If you're making this happen, go. Type in I'm going in the comments and let's make it happen.